Thank you. Sat down beside her and said, "What's in the bowl, bitch?" Was that not how it goes? Anyway, when you do "Bad into Hell" as your third song, it makes you feel like you're fucking 63 years old, I'll tell you what. When I left that dressing room, I was as young as Robbie Williams was when he did Tay Was in Tay. Okay, I want to fuck Robbie Williams. I was as young as, "Do you think I'm sexy and you want my body? Come on, baby, left." No? Okay, let's go this way. Did you know that the first time that we ever played in the UK was in Manchester, England? So I'm as sexy as I was then. Patty?
Hence, you are 63 years old.
So that proves my point. Never fucking argue with a woman. We put out an album last year called Hey Cool Teddy Bear. Okay, a few of you got it.
Now, along with that, there is something that goes along with that. See, secretly, on WikiLeaks, I have all your addresses. And I will be at your house to make sure you fucking listen to that record. See, that fucking internet comes in good for something, doesn't it? I know who you are. So anyway, we're going to do the opening suite to Hank Cool Teddy Bear, which I think is just... you have no idea how much it brought new life to me. And I think it's one of the best things I've ever done. It's a story of a soldier named Patrick who is about to die. And instead of his life flashing backwards, it flashes forward. We're going to do the opening suite to Hank Cool Teddy Bear. Peace on Earth, Living on the Outside in Los Angeles. This is Hank Cool Teddy Bear. Not the way Patrick imagined. Not a sharp pain, like when he sliced his pinky to the bone chopping tomatoes at his old pizza parlor job, or the time he was exploring old man Feeney's construction site and a two-penny nail punctured his Converse. No, this was more of a burn, as if someone was pressing the business end of a branding iron into his ribs. It hurt like a mother. But Patrick was still better off than his pal, Tennessee Tommy. Thank you.
It was a hot
a lot to me like two out of three of you men. Randy, come on here, let me tell you something. Did you know this? How do you know you didn't know this? Oh, Randy said, I usually don't know anything. No, he's from Nashville, Tennessee. That's fucking true. Go ahead, keep playing. Yeah. This song was written by my brother, and I like to call him that, Mr. Jim Steinman. Thank you very much, from Jimmy to you. This song was written on a bet that he couldn't write a song as simple as I Want You, I Need You, I Love You by Elvis Presley. And Jimmy said, you're right, I can't. But I can write this. I want you, I need you. But there ain't no way I'm ever gonna love you. Now don't be sad, cause two out of three ain't bad. I'm holding on, I'm holding on. Jackson is 25 years old, and some nights he plays so good that I just want to fucking kill him. Mr. Justin Avery!
Thank you.
That note was so good that I think that she should let me cop a feel. Do you agree? I heard some women out there say no. I heard the men say yes, but I heard the women say no. Let's take a poll right now. All the men who think I should be able, after that note, to grab her breast, say yes. Yeah! Okay, that's all I'm asking. I'm not asking the women. The men rule. Oh, wait a second. Okay, I forgot. Don't fucking ever argue with a woman. Okay. All the women. Oh, man, I don't want to ask this question. Who think that because, remember how good I hit that note, that I should be able to, let's say, caress. Her breast, say yes. Yes.
Yes. Honey, it's gonna take you about 10 minutes to get through all this shit to find them.
Do you remember it? Now it was longer than 30 seconds because I did this whole thing about caress and grab and cop a feel and all that stuff. But remember in the second verse of the song, I say something about open up your eyes. I've got a big surprise. Well, for you tonight. That's right, from Manchester. I am going to bring out my big surprise. Now, men, if you really don't want to fucking see the big surprise, just turn around and close your fucking eyes, okay? Because the women want to fucking see it. Are you ready?
Let's go. Whip it out, baby.
Now, everybody knows that if I really did bring up my big surprise, I would get arrested, which might be good for album sales. I'm not sure. Probably would. Meatloaf gets arrested by Hankul fucking teddy bear now. So anyway, I just want you to know that this is an exact replica. I went to the body shop, and at the body shop, I whipped it out, and they made a replica. I see you're not buying a fucking word of it.
Shut up!
Anyway, Patricia.
Yes, dear.
Would you like to touch my big surprise?
Shall I touch this big surprise? Everybody's saying no. I'm with you. All right, I'll fuck Paul. I'll touch it.
I'll go get Paul to touch it.
God, you're an idiot. Thank you.
This big surprise is sensitive. I didn't know it was that sensitive. Patty.
Yes, dear.
Can you touch it again?
Of course.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. We got a real pressure cooker going here. Two down, nobody on, no score, bottom of the ninth. There's the windup, and there it is, a line shot up the middle. Look at him go. This boy can really fly. He's rounding first and really turning it on now. He's not letting up at all. He's going to try for second. The ball is bobbled out in center, and here comes the throw, and what a throw. He's going to slide in head first. Here he comes. He's out. No, wait, safe. Safe at second base. This kid really makes things happen out there. Batter steps up to the plate. Here's the pitch, and he's going, and what a jump he's got. He's trying for third. Here's the throw. It's in the dirt. Safe at third. Holy cow, stolen base. Taking a pretty big lead out there, almost scared him to try and pick him off. Pitcher glances over, winds up, and it's butted down the third baseline. The suicide squeeze is on. Here he comes, squeeze play, it's going to be close. Here's the throw, here's the play at the plate. Holy cow, I think he's going to make it.
What's it gonna be, boy? Jess?